Today, I'm showing you exactly how to prepare for your week in just 15 minutes. What to do, what not to do, and how to get the right stuff into your planner. If you're new here, welcome. We chat all about getting more stuff done in less time. So the name of the game is shortcuts in your day so we can smooth out the way for the life we want. So, why plan your week? Here's why. We're human. Some of us are moms. Somebody once said we're in charge of small empires. If we don't have a plan, we'll gravitate toward the things to do that are the fastest and the easiest. And there's two reasons for that. One, we need instant gratification. Our brains love us so much. They just want us to be happy. And our brains know on a very basic level how to get happy fast. So it will steer us toward the fast moving stuff, which isn't always what has to get done, unfortunately. Secondly, we need to multitask a lot of the time. It's part of the job requirement. So we get lots of busy stuff done and the week flies by and we realize we didn't do that thing that kept popping into our heads that, oh, I should really do that. That didn't get done. And that does not feel good inside when you're looking back at your week. When we do have a plan for our weeks and days, we are in control of our time. We have visual reminders. We can stay ahead of interruptions because we know they're coming. And most importantly, we can make sure our weeks and our days have a nice, healthy work-life harmony or mom-adult harmony. I don't like the word balance. I feel like it means I have to balance everything. Harmony. Harmony. Best of all, when we plan our week, we're going to intentionally concentrate on the things that matter to us. Those, oh, I gotta, those thoughts, that's happening because those things matter to us. It matters to us that they get done. So our brain keeps sending signals for them, even though we're not doing them. So let's give them some love. Let's give ourselves some love and get it done. 5 steps. 15 minutes. Step one, whatever appointments you have during the week, get that into your weekly spread first. Check out your month layout and move over any appointments that you have. Home first, work second. It's probably easier to move around a work thing than like a doctor's appointment or a parent-teacher conference or something like that. So this week I've got physical therapy on Tuesday, parent-teacher conferences on Thursday. And also the kids have a half day Thursday. So get those in there. One thing I want to point out is that for this particular week, I had an idea of how I wanted the flow of the week to look before Sunday even came. And I jotted it down in here, as you can see. Write it down as it comes to you. That's what your planner is there for. It works for you. So I'll get into how I structured this in a second. I promise. It's actually pretty important. Step two, check the week prior for any stuff you didn't get done that week. And you're going to move that task to the notes section of your weekly spread, the side part of the week. It usually is on the side part. Sometimes it's on the bottom. And here's why. You are already going to have stuff to do this week. And the truth is, you're going to have to fit this thing that we didn't get done last week somewhere in between that, depending on how important it is. So we're going to let it marinate right there on the side until we can decide its level of importance. So last week was Thanksgiving. I purposefully did not give myself a lot of work to do because the kids had only 2 days of school. And I really want the holidays to be family time. I don't want me on my phone or my laptop all day, and that paves the way for all day video games, if I can help it. By the way, I Frankenplans this happy planner. I wanted to try out both layouts, the vertical and the dashboard, at the same time to get a feel for them. Anyway, the week before is a little more normal-like, and I can see already that I didn't finish gift shopping, and I'm cutting it pretty close here, and I also wanted to get started on some more Etsy products from my Etsy principal shop. The link's in the description. I think everything's 15% off right now, and I'm always putting random things on sale, so go check them out. So those two things go on the side space of the week coming. So that whole thing, looking at the week before and moving the stuff that didn't get done, it shouldn't take more than 2 minutes tops. You're just looking for things that glaringly didn't get done. Step three, we're going to take a few minutes and reflect on the past week, 3 to 5 minutes tops. Some things to think about. Could I have done anything a little more efficiently or with more of a smile or with some graciousness instead of being grumpy? Was I avoiding a project or a goal? Am I nervous or worried about it? Do I think it's too hard? Did I carve out intentional time with my kids? Do I want to do that this week? The goal is to try and see if there's anything that we were struggling with last week and try and flip it more positively this week. If you journal, this might be a great idea to just get a 2-minute journaling session in just to process the week. In October, I actually found a little spot on the bottom of the color block layout that I could use to just reflect. See if you could see it. See? So it's just to think about what went right, what went wrong, learning from mistakes, whatever. Okay, step four, you're going to review any notes, places you have information for goals or projects that you're working on, work projects and home projects, and see if you can fit some tasks in during the week. I'm going to show you mine quickly. I always keep stuff on a clipboard. I am a clipboard maniac. I love these things. I started filling mine out for December. These pages are part of my, look, see, I keep looking back and forth on them. These pages are part of my goal planner that's in my Etsy shop. I did a YouTube live planning out some end of year goals with you guys. I will link it either up here, down here, or in the description. Very quick timeout to explain something here. Long story short, I don't like being told what to do. It probably sounds pretty weird, but if I have a list of like more than three things in a day, my mind like takes it as a demand and I just, no. I lose control, I lose focus for the week. I don't like it. So I'm a big fan of having like no more than three big to-dos in a day. After that, if whatever else you can get done, fantastic. So anyway, my favorite way to sprinkle tasks into my week is to front load Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday with all the big things, all the important things. They are also more or less urgent. And then I use Thursday and Friday as catch-up days, like easy, busy work days. This is a great way to structure your week because a lot of times things take longer than we think they do or we think they should, longer than we were expecting. We get interrupted, we forget one or two tasks that go in between whatever we were doing. We're relying on somebody else to start or finish something before we can move on. And the whole thing just ends up taking longer. So having Thursday and Friday to catch up will make it more likely that you complete the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday things and not have to bring them into the next week. That's what we are trying to avoid. We don't want to have a backlog of things to do. This works well for me for stuff like job stuff, like my blog, like my stuff, our stuff with you, with you guys. And home stuff. Last step, step five, check your house cleaning list to see which rooms you've been avoiding and make a mental note to get to them this week. That's gonna take 1 minute. Some people are different, but I don't put daily cleaning tasks into my planner. I actually have a running list by date of the rooms that I cleaned each day. So all I have to do is look back at the last 7 days and see, okay, this bedroom or that bathroom or whatever didn't get as much love. And then I will make sure to just have it in the back of my head for when I'm picking rooms that I'm cleaning each day. I don't write it down beforehand because my cleaning schedule is I clean one room each day. That's it. So I'll always clean one thing each day. And I just want a refresher of what I may be missing, what room is gonna be next. I'm gonna put this back up. Command hooks, love them. Better than shelves. I don't wanna hit my head on something. The whole thing takes literally 15, maybe 17 minutes to go through each week. And it helps you be prepared to get in the swing of things for when Monday comes. Like I said at the beginning, our jobs are complex and we are responsible for a lot every day. And those things can even change at the drop of a hat. And as long as I know in general which direction we're going, by having this plan, I can steer us back to that path if something gets messed up. Now, do you plan your meals? I specifically left meal planning and prepping out of here since it's not necessarily a task. Like I wouldn't necessarily write cook lunch, eat lunch on my planner. But if you want a meal prep guide, I actually have a blog post and I'm going to link to it down below. It's got some great meal prep shortcuts. It's got an easy way to pick meals. And it's got 3 days of easy meals in case you still need some more ideas. It's pretty thorough. You should check it out. You're now 5 steps and 15 minutes away from a productive, clean, smooth week ahead. You have a plan. You have visual reminders. And most importantly, what matters to you is not being forgotten. I hope you stick around and check out my other videos. Please like and subscribe. It helps my channel out so much. And I'll see you in the next one.